Okay, guys, let's head down there and win those talons from Jean Bisson. Sly, try to keep a low profile when we get close. We don't want him to recognize you. Excuse me, sir. We humble lumberjacks would like to participate in your lumberjack games.
Think you got what it takes to win the Clockwork Talons, eh? Well, I'm sure enough gonna let you play, so long as you pay the entry fee.
Much obliged, partner. We'll, just take our positions for the competition.
Enjoy the moment while you think you still got a chance. It's as close to winning as you'll ever get. This year's first event will be a power chopping contest. Not like anyone's ever gonna beat my record, but let them try. Not bad, Hippo. But watch and learn as I destroy that log without even breaking a sweat.
Okay, Bentley, you're on. Plant the eagle egg on Bisson, and the angry eagle parent should swoop in and throw off his axe timing.
Scores, boys. What you intended to give me was perfect tens, right? So your pink friend knows how to handle an axe. Let's see how you handle a vertical wall of ice. Cane of yours isn't helping you any. Pretty good for a scrawny raccoon. Now, watch and learn as I demonstrate the art of power climbing.
Murray, use those grapples to hook onto Bison. You will need to hook him with all three lines to pull him off the wall.
What? No applause for that masterful display of climbing? Again. Did I ever tell any of you the story about the judge from last year's competition who mistakenly gave me a score other than 10? I see we're tied with only one event to go. Unfortunately for you, I've saved my best event for the last, the spinning log competition.
Okay, looks easy enough. I just need to stay out of the water.
Give you that. But now, watch how a skilled log roller does it.
This is crazy. John Bisson's got those judges so intimidated, there's no way he can lose.
You're right, Murray. Those guys need to go. Okay, I'm just making this up on the fly, but what if I were to lure the judges one by one into that cave? Once inside, you two will knock them out and take their clothes.
Ingenious! When all three judges have been restrained, we'll be able to don our disguises and take their place at the judges' table. Sly, you can use the alarm clock gadget to distract the judges and lure them into the cave.
That's a great plan, Sly, but you'll have to move fast. Once John Bisson finishes the log rolling event, the gig is up.
Thank you.
consequences for incorrect scores. Wait a second. You aren't the judges I hired. It's the scrawny raccoon and his annoying friends. Well, if you want the challenge, then why don't you just take him?
Oh, my aching head. Those talons really pack a punch. Sly! Murray! Wake up!
Yeah, I'm awake, but not so loud. I have a splitting headache.
Where are we? What's going on?
This looks like the sawmill control room. Bisson must have thrown us in here for interrogation later. I, for one, would like to escape before he returns.
It looks like we're pretty well sealed in here. Unless...
Unless what?
Unless you can fit through that hole.
I think I could squeeze through there. I'll drop down and try to free you guys from the outside. If there's any trouble, I'll call with this walkie-talkie. You might be able to help me with these sawmill controls.
While you guys do that, I'll try prying open that steel door. Given enough time, I might be able to make some progress.
Sounds like a plan. Good luck, Bentley, and remember to shout if I can help you from up here.
Bentley, you okay? I can't see you from in here, but I heard the fall.
I'll be fine. Just give me a moment to catch my breath.
Well now, Candy Britches. I should have figured a puny turtle like you'd find a rat hole to squirm through.
Well, I just dropped my glasses, had to come pick them up.
I ain't like you, boy. I ain't stupid. When y'all were unconscious, me and my boys paid a visit to your hideout and found all them clockwork parts. Lucky thing, too. Arpeggio is willing to plunk down a king's ransom for the whole lot. I even threw in the talons.
You sold all the clockwork parts? Arpeggio has them all?
I wouldn't expect one of your kind to understand the finer points of commerce. You turtles are too stupid to know a woodcutter from a woodchuck.
That's it! Time I showed you just how stupid we turtles really are. Sly, on my command.
I hear ya.
Prepare yourself, Bisson. En garde.
Okay, Walnut. Get ready for a smushin'.
Call out which lever... I should pull.
Flames!
10-4.
Lock!
Alright.
Flames!
Done.
Lock the way!
Yep.
Sauce?
There you go.
Flames!
Uh-huh.
Lock the way!
On it.
Flames! Flames!
How's that? Okay.
Sauce?
Bam!
Fire!
Okay.
Wait!
On it.
Sauce!
10-4.
Come on in here, boys. Let's get this varmint.
Hook him!
Bam!
Log! Log!
Alright.
Looks like I'm tougher than you are clever.
Call out which lever I should pull.
Drop him! Flames!
Okay. There you go.
Cook him!
Alright.
Come on in here, boys. Let's get this varmint.
Logs!
10-4.
Flames! 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 Flames!
Done.
Cook him!
Bam!
Let him go!
Yep.
Logs!
Uh-huh.
Blades! Blades!
Eat dynamite, turtle!
Fire up! Saws!
On it.
Drop up!
Bam!
Sizzle his gizzle!
Yep.
Come out, boys. Let's get to killing.
Flames! Flames!
10-4.
Flames! Flames! Let them go!
Done.
Fire up!
There you go.
Flame up! Let them go!
All right.
Tarnation! I've been done in by some four-eyed turtle. Times have changed.
Once again, brains triumph over brawn.
Good job, little buddy. That was some fast thinking.
Don't forget about me!
You did a great job opening that door, Murray.
Thanks!
Okay, enough patting ourselves on the back. If we're going to get the clockwork parts back, we need to get onto that blimp.
The silo battery isn't far. If we run, we can make it.
Enough talk, let's move!
Shake a leg, that blimp's on its way.
As we shut ourselves into the Northern Light battery, it became black. For a few long minutes, we just sat there in darkness. No one dared to talk for fear that Jean Bassan's men might discover where we were hiding. Time seemed to have stopped. And then, we felt it. We were being lifted up to Arpeggio's blimp. It was all so strange. The focus of all our schemes had been stolen from us. Our clockwork parts were gone. Looking around the inside of the battery, I knew we all felt it. Failure. I was twitchy and ready for action. Any action. Bentley tried to make some sense of the situation by drawing up meaningless plans. But Murray took it the worst. He just sat there sobbing while the team van floated away over the horizon. That van was his life. I knew I'd have to find a way to make it up to him.
Thank you.
east across the Atlantic Ocean, stowaways on a giant airborne fortress. Though time was short, we made sure to study up on our unknowing host, Arpeggio. While attending a prestigious boarding school, the young Arpeggio excelled in all subjects, but he never managed to keep up with the other boys physically. Sadly, his wings, due to their small size, were useless for flight. Furious at his feeble body, he focused his powerful mind to search for a cure in the works of the Italian Renaissance masters. Their notebooks provided the springboard for this sinister young genius, and it wasn't long before the Claw Gang took him on as chief inventor. His talents must have been at work repurposing all the clockwork parts for their criminal schemes, and now this mastermind is in possession of all the parts. It's only a matter of time before he puts them back together, and when that happens, well, I'm not gonna let that happen.
Yeah.
have picked up large magnetic fields radiating from inside that blimp. If Arpeggio's already started reassembling clockwork, that's where you'll find him.
Sounds good. I'm on my way.
Don't waste any time here, Sly. Get to the blimp and take some recon photos. To build a plan, we need to know how close they are to reviving clockwork.
Relax, Bentley. I've got it under control.
Thank you.
calm down, Bentley. He might be in one piece, but he doesn't appear to be, you know, alive. Let's stick to the format here. How about some recon photos?
You're right. We need to be informed to create a plan of action. Try to get a shot of Clockwork's head, a mech egg, and one of those spinning magnetic inducers. They seem important to the procedure. But stay away from the guards. If you get detected, we won't have time for a second chance. These magnetic inducers seem to be holding the clockwork parts together.
Thank you.
mastermind behind this blip and the source of all our problems. I can't believe it! She must have been working with Arpeggio all along! I don't need to study those photos to see the writing on the wall. Clearly, Neela and Arpeggio have conspired together to rebuild Clockwork, and it looks like they're dangerously close to realizing their goal.
Look, Bentley, I know it's not your style, but I need a quick plan of attack. Try to think of a way, any way, to stop Clockwork from getting reassembled.
Well, those magnetic inducers seem to be holding the parts together. If you reverse their polarity, it should pull Clockwork apart. Unfortunately, the inducer speed control station is locked down tight. Pickpocket keys for the four patrolling guards to get at it. Then you'll need to manually reverse the polarity of each inducer deck at the top of their rotation.
Consider it done.
Thank you. What's all this then? The magnets have been reversed. But, by Jove, it seems to have locked the clockwork parts into place. Excellent.
Sly Cooper, of course this would be your doing.
Ah, Mr. Cooper, no doubt you believed a reversal would pull the old bird apart, eh? But it seems to have had quite the opposite effect. I'm truly grateful. When fully powered up, I'll join myself to its circuits and be born anew.
All this because you can't fly. You're pathetic.
Immortality! Immortality is what I seek. The other Claw Gang members were much too short-sighted. They were satisfied using the clockwork parts to drive their various trivial schemes. But not me. No. I saw them for what they really were. The keys to life eternal.
So, what? You had Neela put me on the scent back in Cairo, and then waited while I stole the parts from the other Claw Gang members. All the while not arousing any suspicion that you were behind it all?
You make it sound easy, Cooper. I had to carry your pathetic gang through that first set of heists. I was overjoyed when Arpeggio let me toss you in jail. I could finally go after the parts myself.
Ah, but acquiring all the parts was only half the equation. Think, Cooper. What kept Clockwork alive for thousands of years?
He was fueled by his hatred for my family.
Splendid! That's right! Hatred! Putting his gears and wires together was child's play, compared with accumulating that much hatred.
You can't make people hate.
Oh, my poor naive boy. My meticulous mind has found a way. As your hippopotamus friend will attest, spice consumption makes you both angry and susceptible to hypnosis. The Contessa, hypnotist extraordinaire, devised a way to command people through the use of flashing lights. I've created this blimp to be a massive transmitter of those precise light frequencies. The only problem I faced was finding a suitable source of light waves.
The Northern Lights! You've been collecting Northern Light energy so you could hypnotize everyone beneath the blimp.
Ah, hypnotize those who'd eaten food covered in illegal spice. Thank goodness for Dimitri. Through his nightclub, he got the whole city to consume the spice.
You're going to Paris to unleash a hypnotic light show of hate. That's outlandishly cruel.
Cruel, perhaps, but necessary to give Clockwork his spark of immortality. Ah well, my new body awaits me. Be a dear, Neela, and keep him covered. Ta-ta!
Stupid Arpeggio. I double-crossed the Cooper gang, Interpol, and Carmelita. What made you think I wouldn't do the same to you?
This is preposterous! You're my protege, not the next candidate for my immortality. I demand you exit the clockwork frame or...
Behold, Heracla is born!
As we all know, things are looking grim. Neela has joined herself to the clockwork frame and the union has produced Clockla. She's out and free to terrorize the world. This blimp is still in motion to Paris. I can only assume Arpeggio's autopilot will activate the hate hypnosis light show. If that happens, there'll be no stopping Clockla. She'll be immortal. But we still have a chance. In her new form, she'll need to draw a lot of energy from this blimp's engines to stay strong. If we can disable the engines, that should be enough to weaken her to a state in which we can attack. Getting at these engines will require all three of us to work together in perfect harmony. We've pulled off some tough jobs in the past, but they were just the warm-up round for what we'll be going through tonight.
You along, Bentley. What do you need me to do?
Pickpocket the guard's keys to the engine room. Once you've got the door open, I'll take over.
Okay, you should take your position. It's not gonna take me long to lighten these guys of their keys.
get to bounce up to the next level. If I'm reading this right, it looks like you need to bomb those power nodes to get into the control room. Once that door is open, you'll be able to shut this engine down for good.
Engines that needs to be disabled. I won't lie to you, Murray. This is going to be a tough job that requires both our skills.
My skills? Okay, Bentley, if you say so.
First, I'll need to hack the station's controlling access to the engine room. Then, Murray, you'll need to head inside and use your muscle to finish the job.
The Murray will be ready to go.
We'll be right back.
Hey, pal. Looks like you'll need to lift all those giant cylinders. Once they're locked in the up position, you'll be able to take them out from the top level. Heads up, pal. You've got company. Power stations located throughout this blimp. I'll need you to take out all the power stations and then pry open the door by hand.
No sweat, Sly.
Thank you.
stern, buddy.
Careful, Sly. This place is packed with laser security. First, you'll need to make your way to the far end of this room. Then jump up to the second level to get at the engine room control center.
Thank you.
You're carrying some heavy explosives, Bentley, because that engine isn't small.
It just so happens that there's a ready supply of explosives already available on the blimp. Lock one of these TNT barrels up to that engine room to destroy it.
Sounds easy enough. What's the catch?
The initial payload in that TNT barrel won't be powerful enough to do the job. If you pick up 3 magnetic chargers, you should achieve the necessary blast force to destroy the engine. It's simple, really. Just get close to the chargers, and they'll automatically attach to your barrel.
All right, let's blow stuff up.
Thank you.
With the TNT barrel all charged up, it's time to deliver the payload to that engine.
The last time anyone puts that engine to use.
In an unexpected windfall, I've been contacted by Inspector Fox over the shortwave radio. She's well aware of the dire situation we all face if Plakla becomes immortal and has agreed to join forces with us, so that we can destroy the robotic bird. The only catch is that she's unable to locate this blimp on her radar. To help her hone in on our position, we'll need to boost the strength of 4 local radio towers. Once Inspector Fox is in range, she'll take one of us on board to act as a tail gunner in a dogfight against Clockla. This is it. We don't have time for another plan. We're almost over Paris, and if that hate hypnosis light show goes off, well, you know the story.
Okay, Sly, we need to send Carvalita a radio pulse so she can home in on the blimp. Do that, I'll need you to get on top of 4 very tall towers. They're too big to climb and too tall to jump up normally.
What's this all got to do with this thing you've got me wearing?
It's an experimental mega jump pack. By pressing the L1 button, you'll perform a huge jump, so be careful.
All right, sounds like fun. Not flirty chit chat?
Nice shooting! Oh, yeah!
my cop. That was some terrific shooting.
Sly! Sly! We've got a serious problem here. Lakala's looking mighty upset, and I think she's going to take it out on us.
I'm coming, guys. Hold on.
Oh, I feel sick. Oh, sorry, Bentley.
Neela, but you're still the low-down, backstabbing coward we've beaten time and time again. This won't be any different.
Be brave while you can, Cooper. I might not have the immortality born of pure hate, but I feel something. Some power growing within me.
Come on.
We did it.
Right on.
It's an emotional moment.
Die, Zex, die! My hate will smash you.
Watch out. That thing's still kicking.
Lakla mentioned something about a hate chip. It sounded like the source of her power.
If we remove it, she might stop attacking.
Then let's do a little open head surgery. I'll pry open that beak so that Bentley can go to town with his bombs.
And there we were, at the end of the road. The Claw Gang had been defeated and the clockwork parts lay scattered around in heaps. Yet, despite the explosion, they remained pristine. It was as if nothing could ever hurt them. Carmelita cursed herself for showing up too late to get a few shots in on Clockla. So she took it out on what was close at hand, the hate chip. And just like that, it was over. Without that core piece, that essential center of clockwork, there was nothing left. The parts aged before our eyes as if time had finally caught up with the ancient bird. How ironic that Carmelita, a police officer, would be the one to lift the curse from the Cooper family. The menace of clockwork would never again rise to threaten me or my children. True to her nature, she informed us that we were all under arrest. But one look at my gang told me that we were in no shape for a fast getaway. So I offered to go peacefully in exchange for letting my friends walk. They'd taken some bruises through all of this, but I was surprised, shocked really, to see them leave their gear behind as they walked away. Their wounds were deeper than I'd imagined. Those guys were hurting. Carmelita's old police unit soon arrived. With me in custody, her name was cleared, and she even got a well-deserved promotion. It was the least I could do. The ride to HQ started with us sitting in silence, trying to read each other's thoughts. As the reality of my capture started to sink in, she began to relax, and we got to talking. We spoke freely about our previous adventures, comparing notes and even getting in a few laughs. Then we started talking about, well, everything. Books, music, art. It was like we were on a first date. She even showed me the bottle she'd been saving for the special occasion of my arrest. My heart sank when she realized that our short flight across town had already taken 2 hours, a fact I kind of clued into after seeing the Eiffel Tower float by 17 times. She went forward to ask the pilot what was up, and it looked like my pals had left me a little going-away present before taking off. Floating away on the night breeze, I could faintly make out Carmelita's voice.
I'll find you, Cooper! I'll be seeing you soon, Ringtail.